Setting up a digital piano in your home is a pretty straightforward task. There's only a few things that you need to consider. If you purchase a piano from a local dealer, they invariably will deliver it fully assembled. That's just part of the service. But if you purchase a piano online, then it will arrive in a box and you will then need to put the piano together yourself, which is a fairly straightforward task, but it is a two-man job, especially when you position the top of the piano on the bass. Unlike acoustic pianos, digital pianos are pretty hardy and they don't really suffer from changes in temperature or humidity. So that's great because it means you're free to position them pretty much wherever you like, against a radiator, in a basement, or perhaps even under a window. Don't put them in direct sunlight because that'll fade the cabinet. And also try to avoid using a socket that is shared with another electrical device, as sometimes this can cause interference. A room and its furnishings can affect the sound. For example, if you have a wooden floor, that can make the sound quite lively. Or if you have a really thick shag pile carpet, that can deaden the sound. And there's a few things you can adjust on the piano to make it sound the very best in the room that it's in. You could, for example, add a little bit of reverb. So if you have a particularly dead sound, then you can increase the reverb. You could also adjust brilliance. So if you had, say, a particularly lively room, you could just take the brilliance down a little bit to compensate. Some digital pianos will even let you adjust the sound on a note-by-note basis. So if, for example, you were in a room that was particularly resonant and certain notes were standing out, then you could find those individual notes and just perhaps take the edge off them like that. So you can see that G is just ever so slightly quieter. Great tool for making sure that the piano sounds at its absolute best for the room that it's going to be in. When it comes to sitting at the piano, there's two things you need to consider. Firstly, how far away you sit from the piano, and secondly, the height of the stool. So in terms of distance from the piano, sit on the stool, on the edge of the stool, with both feet firmly on the floor, and if you can touch both ends of the keyboard with only a slight feeling of stretch, then you're in the right position. In terms of the height of the stool, an adjustable stool is best, but if you haven't got one, then a cushion is fine. And make sure that the height is such that when you put your hands on the keyboards, your wrist and your forearm form a straight line. And finally, don't leave the piano switched on. That's not because of any danger of long-term damage, far from it, but it's more a case of a waste of electricity. Some digital pianos have a feature called auto off, which will automatically turn the piano off after a pre-selected period of time, which you can choose. And this is great for kids because they will often play the piano and then run off to play and forget to turn it off.